Alright, what is up you guys? Welcome back to the Gentleman TV. So I got the staff signings without you guys. I thought you guys probably wouldn't want to watch that. I thought this probably wouldn't take too long, so I thought I'd just show you guys some of the team option and whatnot and show you guys some of the players we could possibly get. Look at that. Look at that big three of players. LeBron, D Wade, and Melo. I mean, if we can get any of those guys right now, we'd be in great shape. I mean, honestly, could you imagine getting LeBron on this team with two of whoever I draft? So looking at this team right now, looking at Eric Bledsoe, he's one of the players that is asking for a re-signing right now. And I'm kind of considering trading away some players because I do sort of want to get rid of some players that might be high salary. So if you look at this, looks like Paul Millsap's our highest with $9.5 million. I think if we trade away Paul Millsap right now, we might actually be able to get even somebody who's young. And, oh, they're trying to offer us back Monte Ellis. I'm not giving up that first-round pick, though, honestly. I would take that without the first-round pick. But, yeah, let's move on. No, got to keep going, and let's see. No. I really don't think all these trades that they're offering me are that great. Even this Avery Bradley one isn't that great. Zach Randolph, maybe. No. Not Jarrett Jack. Come on, we need something good here. I mean, we're giving up Paul Millsap, and that would be a good trade right here if we weren't giving up a pick. That's really what's the concern. I mean, ooh, I like this one. Getting Oladipo? Oh, man. I might have to get Oladipo. I like this trade, honestly. Drop that salary cap, get a younger player. I think this is definitely a good trade. Because honestly, I don't know how much I'm really going to be doing with that second round draft pick when you think about it. I think right now it's really just all about my first two picks. I think those picks are going to be the ones that actually come up and do anything for me. And we already have another second round pick, don't we? Yeah, we have our own second round pick, so we should be fine for right now. And let's keep going. Let's see what we're doing here. Can we trade away anybody else? Would it be worth it to trade away anybody else? Because I want to fill up enough room to be able to sign somebody. I don't think anybody else has that big of a salary, though, that we need to be trading them away. I don't know. I think we look fine for now. Oh, let's sim past team/player options. And Eric Bledsoe is the only one we need to re-sign. Let's see. He had before $3.73 million. We'll offer that to him again. I think that's definitely fair. I'll easily give him that much money, honestly. For Eric Bledsoe, and let's see. Oh, looks like we're going into an interview here, and whoa, oh my goodness. So he's raising the stakes a lot right now, and looks like that's about as much as we're going to offer him. Let's see, let's offer this and see if he accepts it. I think this trade, I mean, not this trade, this, I don't know why we're not offering him as much as he wants. I don't know why we have to go lower, but, I mean, yeah, I think that's, yeah, I don't know, I don't know why we can't just offer him what he wants. Do I have to be a higher level in something than that? And, oh, yeah, the rest of these guys, they're willing to take the low amounts of money, which I'm fine with. I'm willing to offer them low money. I don't even know who have, ooh, emotional, I don't have emotional intelligence right now, so I'm just gonna offer it to the guys who have the very, very small salaries. And let's see, wow, yeah, I didn't even have to look at that one. It's just in the thousands, the total offer. And yeah, looks like he wants to test free agency, so I think we'll sign Parker. Yeah, I think Parker's probably gonna be somebody we sign. I want to try to sign Parker and Randall or Parker and Wiggins. Honestly, if Randall and Wiggins are available, I'll have to kind of sign them, but I mean, I highly doubt both are going to be available. Actually, in fact, I think whoever made this draft class honestly made Jabari probably the worst out of the three, which, I mean, probably will end up being the result when you think about it. I think Wiggins and Randall are going to end up being better, but Jabari's still going to be nasty, so let's see. And I'm liking this draft. The draft looks for some reason better. I like the presentation a little bit better. Of course, we got the new commission here, so I'm getting hyped to get into this draft, man. All right, so who picks first? Is it the Bobcats who get first overall pick? I believe it is. Yeah, I think it's the Bobcats with the first overall pick. So, all right, when are we going to get into this first overall pick here? And no, I'm sorry, it's the Hawks, because we were going to trade the Hawks for their first overall pick. Did we, like, trade the... Oh, no, Bobcat's up at 11. Julius Randle. Ah, all right. So I think I'll probably take Parker then Wiggins. Or Wiggins then Parker, whichever one I see first, yeah. So let's just... Let's take Wiggins right here. Look at him. Yeah, look at his face. That does not look too much like Wiggins, but he looks very good. Potential A+, overall A+. He's expected to go in the top three. So I'm thinking that's going to be top three for Andrew Wiggins. And oh, wow. Wow, did they just... Wow, they just said Andrew Wiggins' name? Wow. That was pretty impressive. Alright, who else? Where's Jabari? Where's Jabari's? There he is. Alright, so we got... I just call him Jabari's. So we got Jabari Parker and Andrew Wiggins in this draft. So, I mean, honestly, the future of this team is looking very good right now, honestly. I think tanking for a season was a good idea. I don't think we should tank again in complete honesty. I don't think that's going to be a good move, but, the Orlando Magic trying to make us a deal right now. Oh, come on. You gotta be joking me with this offer right now. Wiggins for Harkless and their fifth round pick. That's just not worth it, dude. Honestly, like, maybe their fourth round pick. I don't know, because I would have taken Marcus Smart and Maurice. No, not even that, man. Those first three picks were really just a tier above everybody else, I think. I think that was huge getting them, and, I mean, I don't know if they're going to be worth trying to trade for somebody really good, but I don't know. I'm probably going to hold on to them for now. I'm not sure they're worth trading because they're going to be players that I can have on this franchise for a while. And by the way, guys, I've been listening a lot to your comments, and I've decided I'm going to be 12-minute quarter games now, but I'm going to be simming 9 and then playing the 10th game, and then for the last two games of the season, I'll play them because those probably will hold a lot of weight when you think about it. Because, I mean, if I'm simming every game, I'm going to be losing a lot more than I would if I played every game. Because when you play every game, you're more able to tailor the team to your playing style. So, I mean, this is going to be a season that, I mean, I don't usually sim every game and stuff, so I'm really going to have to base a team off of what the overalls are, not like who I like playing with. So, yeah, definitely going to be an interesting season. Let's see the draft summary, and wow, look at the top three picks. Those three obviously were very, very good, and then you got Marcus Smart, who kind of drops down a lot, but... Those big three were really, really key getting, and wow, this team is looking absolutely great right now. I'm really happy with Wiggins and Parker. So, I mean, this team right now, man, we got Wiggins, Parker, we got Eric Bledsoe. I mean, who does our team not have right now? Except for a lot of people, obviously. But, I mean, anyway, our team's looking really good right now. I'm happy with them. And let's go into rookie signing. Look at that. Jeez, Aaron Kraft. Aaron Kraft doesn't need too much. And we complete a goal, complete another goal. Getting VC in the bank on that first one. Now, alright, free agency. Let's see, is LeBron out there? Accepted offers. And, oh, yes, so we... Oh, no, I'm sorry. I thought we had Eric Bledsoe. Oh, alright, here's our chance with LeBron. Oh, my God, here we are with LeBron, dude. Oof. Alright, he wants a lot of money. That's not extremely surprising that he wants a lot of money, obviously. So, yeah. I'm not 100% surprised by that. And, oof. Okay. Yeah, he's really set on that amount of money. And why can't we just offer him the right amount? Yeah, he keeps saying it's a start. Okay, he obviously doesn't want this. Why can't we just offer him... Yeah, see, that's where I think it is. I think I need to get leveled up if I'm going to be able to sign free agents with any sort of... I don't know, that's stupid, though. Stupid that I can't actually offer him what he wants. And, alright, I guess... Can we trade somebody away at this point in the season? Does it even let us? And, let's see. We're at front office. And, yeah, that's where trades is. Alright, going to front office team roster... who has a high salary? Whoops. Anywhere we can... It's not... Yeah, there's nothing there for trades. Oh, come on. You gotta be kidding me. I don't know what we're gonna do here, because I mean, I don't know if we had enough if we like improved our salary cap, if we could sign him. But let's see what Wade wants, or Kobe or Carmelo or any of these guys. We need Bledsoe back. Honestly, we really do need Bledsoe back. I feel like there's so many good free agents out there right now that we got to sign at least one of these guys. I mean, we can't go away without signing anybody on this free agent list. I mean, there's a chance for them to make an absolutely superstar lineup with these guys. All right, let's see what Melo wants. And again, it's doing the exact same thing. It just wasn't worth it. It honestly was not worth it, because it's not gonna let me go through with it. All right, Wade, same exact thing's gonna happen. Yeah, I miss it by what, a million? Yeah, about 1.06 million, and I can't go up any higher. That needs. Am I doing? Guys, please post in the comments, and no need to call me an idiot or whatever. Just explain to me why I can't. Is there a button that you press to negotiate the offer contract? There has to be something I'm doing wrong here. There has to be something that I'm doing wrong, because this is just. All right, Kobe, sign Kobe, $17 million a year, and we offer him $14.5 million. Like, oh my God, man. I mean, getting Kobe on this team would be great. But I mean, what about Granger, Collison, or Bosch? I mean, any of them would be good. Honestly, any guy on this list would be good right now. Come on, Bosch. Oh my, how much? I'm barely missing it. He keeps offering a little bit less than we can get him that he wants. I don't know why we can't just give him what he wants right now. Oh my God, LeBron on the same team as Jabari and Andrew Wiggins? Like, come on, we would be sick right now. And oh, looks like we're losing PJ Tucker. And oh, wow. So we've lost all those guys, but LeBron is. We gotta try this. We gotta try it. You don't have enough room in the salary cap for LeBron James. You can only sign. What? Come on, man. Oh. So can we offer a deal to anybody at this point? Danny Granger, we're not offering him what he wants. Alright, there has to be something that I did wrong. I don't think it's worth it. Maybe we just wait till next season. I don't know how long of a contract that LeBron's going to have, though, when you think about it. Because, I mean, LeBron is, like, he was looking for a five-year deal. He wants to be on a team for a while now, and that's kind of scary. Because, I mean, alright, I'm trying this one more time. It's not letting me do anything, and this is frustrating me so much. Maybe this just isn't worth it. I don't know. This is so annoying, though. This is honestly so annoying. Whatever. I can't. Ah, we lost LeBron. We lost the chance of LeBron. Ah, that's painful. Alright. Let's get into whatever training camps is. I don't think training camps should be too strenuous or too stressful like that was. Alright. Yeah, let's see. I'll send Wiggins. There, I think Wiggins could have a good time. I can't afford any of these. All right, so I will not send him, it looks like, and we might as well just advance to next season, I guess, because there's really nothing else I can do at this point. So, oh wow, yeah. So we, as I said, you guys, or I skipped the staff signing. So you guys didn't get to see. I didn't really sign anybody that great, though. And, yeah, that's unfortunate. Whatever. I guess he's laying out those same goals that he had for me before. Except now it's getting Andrew Wiggins a certain amount of minutes a game, and now that's on 12-minute quarters. It should be a little bit easier to get him 24 minutes a game. I'm not sure if that was all relative to the amount of minutes, but who knows, whatever. And, well, yeah, that looks like it's just about it, guys. Let's actually check out the rosters and see where anybody went. I'm hoping to see some shakeups in the rosters. Let's look for anybody. Let's look for where LeBron may have gone. Oh, Wade's back on the Heat. All right. And, oh, my goodness. LeBron on the Utah Jazz. Wow. Where'd anybody else? Oh, no way. Melo and Granger. Melo, Kobe, and Granger on the same team. Wow. Look at that Pacers. The Pacers team still looks good, but that Lakers team is the team to beat right now. I don't know. We're looking pretty good, too. Lakers team may be the team to beat, but we have some potential on the squad right now. Our top four guys, I should say. I don't know how I'm going to set up this lineup. Probably Bledsoe, Oladipo, then Jabari, Wiggins maybe. I feel like Wiggins probably has better. I don't know. How do you guys think I should set up my lineup? Make sure to post that in the comments, guys. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you haven't. I hope you guys enjoyed this. And I'll make sure to bring you the first game coming up soon. All right, guys. Peace. I'm out.